Welcome back to Penn Basketball Weekly, presented by PNC. I'm Joe Torti, joined by head coach Steve Donahue. Coach, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure, Joe. Great to be here.
Coach, I'm glad that you found the place, because it's got to feel like you haven't been here in a long time. You're in the middle of an 8-game road stretch. What's that been like this early in the season? You're not going to be back here playing a game until after Christmas. Your last game here was before Thanksgiving.
And then we're here for 9 straight.
Right.
Just a crazy schedule. It's very difficult. In some ways, I like it. I like the change of scenery. I like the adversity. I like the strength of the opponent we've been playing. So when you get back here, you almost really appreciate it. If you can play well away from this place, I think you develop really good habits that help you win games. And I think you'll see that when we get back here after we get through all these games.
Coach, you've had a couple of unique experiences in the last 2 games. We'll start with the Monmouth game, a 4 overtime win. What was that like for you and your team?
It was a crazy experience. Played well in the first half, got us a comfortable lead, and like a good team they are, they came at us. And then our doing, I think we did some things real poorly offensively during stretches. After it's all said and done, really proud of our ability to fight through the adversity, 2 buzzer beaters to continue the game. You don't usually win that game. And then fall down by 5 in the 4th overtime, throw out a 1-3-1, get some loose balls, makes big shots, and to win a game like that on the road is, it's a credit to the kids, and I love the grit we showed, and I think it bodes well for the future, because I do think these guys handle adversity well.
You beat a team in Monmouth that's always in the NCAA tournament conversation. You have to turn your attention quickly to a team that's always in the NCAA tournament in Villanova, playing in a unique experience, the Jake Nevin Fieldhouse. Tough team, ranked 4 in the country. They're probably going to go up, considering some of the things that have happened recently. What was that like as well?
Well, in Villanova now, I think we forget here in Philadelphia sometimes, the stretch over the last 5 years has been incredible. I mean, they're, if not the best team in the nation over that stretch, 1 or 2. And then to play in that facility against a veteran team, very difficult. I thought in the first half we competed very well and we didn't make shots. Second half, I thought we made shots and didn't compete as well as we had in the first half. You got to put them together. You obviously, you don't have much margin for error. Our 2 best scorers, our 2 young sophomores, did fairly well in stretches, but it's a difficult spot for both of those kids. I'm talking about AJ and Ryan. But I also think they both came through it playing fairly well in that environment, hopefully grow from it and get better down the road based on playing that kind of competition.
Looking big picture, you know, the Ivy League recently has gone really aggressive scheduling. The schools have played like Villanova, Wisconsin. There are some fantastic scheduled opponents that have been here. What does that say about the state of the league recently here?
Well, I think there's, you can look at it in recruiting first. The league has gotten so much better with the level of player, the size of the player, the athleticism of the player. We've always been a well-coached league based on the kids you're coaching, I think with style play. But to go out and challenge now these teams, and I think we all feel that, one, it helps us get ready for the Ivy, but two, it puts us on another stage where we think we can continue to attract kids that want to play that kind of schedule.
Looking ahead at the rest of your schedule, you mentioned a couple more games on the road. Start out with Howard. What do you know about them and what challenges they've been
at? I mean, they play a crazy schedule. They essentially played 8 games on the road against really good competition. Haven't won one, but first home game we will be for them. That's a challenge, just for a team that's hungry for a win on their home court for the first time. Then we have Lafayette, who's, you know, Franny O and his offense and how much he wants to beat us, and you know, just from a standpoint that he was here and the familiarity, 2 good challenges. And then you end up with Dayton, a really good team and a sold out arena to wrap this first semester up. 3 great challenges to finish off strong in the first semester.
November is drawing to a close. You packed in a ton of games in November. How close is this team on the court versus your vision for what you hope they could be in the preseason?
You know, I'm pleased in the sense that I think we're competing well. I think we're a top 20 right now defensive rebounding team. we take care of the basketball. We have to improve on essentially on two things on the offensive end and one on the defensive end. We're fouling too much, giving away too much on reaching and just silly fouls. Offensive end, decision-making's got to get better. We're still not a great decision-making. We take care of the ball, but I think we take hard shots. And then we got to do a better job of being poised to make open shots. Open standstill threes, plays at the rim that are open, and then free throws. That's where our focus is. If we can, I don't think we're close to where we can be in 2 months, in particular on an offensive team. I think we can be a great offensive team. If we continue to grow our defense and we grow our offense like I think we can, then I think we have a chance to really challenge.
Coach, we'll be watching for that. Thanks for spending a few minutes with us.
Great. Thanks for having me, Joe.
This has been Penn Basketball Weekly presented by PNC.